As discussed with the Director General of Police of Karnataka, yesterday on his own he offered that I can't provide you access to the MLAs, but if you write a letter to them and if they give a consent, I'll provide you access to those MLAs who agree to see you. Before that, naturally, what I say to DGP is immediately conveyed to the BJP leaders who are controlling my Congress MLAs in the hotel. So immediately statements came, we don't want to meet Digvijay Singh. All of them in a prescribed format signed and released it to the press, which again proved my point that they are being held captive and they are being made to sign in duress, which has been my allegation from the day one. Now I gave my letter to the DG, the Director General of Police Karnataka, Mr. Praveen Sood, where I have requested that as desired by you, I am giving you the signed letters to 18 of my Congress MLAs, which you had promised me to deliver to them. The only thing which I wanted, requested him to assure me, was that it should be delivered to the person to whom it is addressed. And I'll be grateful if the police also videographs handing over the letter to the letter to whom it has been addressed, I'll be satisfied. After that, if they don't want to meet me, I'm quite happy. I'm satisfied. To which he refused. Anyway, I have given this letter, handed it over to him this afternoon, to which he said he will respond immediately. Yesterday, I had requested the Honorable High Court of Karnataka to direct the DGP to allow me to meet my voters as I'm a candidate of the Rajya Sabha, which was dismissed and posted for hearing on the 26th of March on the plea that this very issue is with the Honorable Supreme Court. Now, with the I'm awaiting the reply to my letter by the Director General of Police, and with that I'll again go to the court, High Court, Honorable High Court of Bangalore, to say that now first the police prevented me from entering a public place, hotel. Under what law, they refused to answer me. Then I said, allow me to talk to them. Not allowed. Okay, at your suggestion, I am writing a letter. Now the DGP says, not allowed. What do I do? So now, I am sending these letters through a courier to the desired place, that is Ramada Hotel, where they are staying. I have requested the DGP to at least allow these letters to be given by the courier to the individual MLAs. Now I am awaiting, but my hunch is I have full sympathy with the Director General of Police. He is under tremendous pressure, and my allegation is from the pressure from the Chief Minister of Karnataka, Mr. Yedurappa, I charged Mr. Yedurappa that he has pressurized the DGP not allow me to meet my Congress legislators, and his police is preventing me to meet them, to talk to them, and not also make me send my letters to them. This is a power game which the BJP has scripted in this whole country, which is conceived, authored and executed by the BJP, of which Mr. Amit Shah, the Home Minister, is the person behind all this operation, which you people call Operation Lotus. It is nothing but Operation Money Bag. They have huge sums of money. This happened in Karnataka, where 25 to 35 crores were given to the MLAs. And I had given a statement on the 2nd, 3rd March 2020 in the parliament, outside the parliament, to the press, that 5 crores advance and installments of 5 to 10 crores till the vote confidence, which again I have been proved correct. I don't know how many of them have taken the money. I don't have any evidence, so I'm not going to level any charge against the 22 MLAs who are there. But I have these phone recordings of BJP ex-Chief Minister Mr. Shivraj Singh Chauhan and MLA and ex-Chief Minister Mr. Narottam Mishra offering money to my Congress MLAs. That evidence I have got. All these events prove a point that the BJP leaders who are under investigation on charges of corruption, Vyapam case, e-tendering case, Madhyam scam, recruitment of transport constables, and also number of other scams of Sihast, where huge sums were taken by the ministers, even in a religious Sihast Kumbh Mela. That is their fear, and also the honey trap in which some of the senior BJP leaders are involved. This is the reason why they don't want this government to continue. The money is being provided by Mr. Amit Shah. The planes are being chartered by the BJP. The hotel bills are being paid by BJP. And also, the money is being provided by contractors who surreptitiously and fraudulently, by maneuvering and manipulating the e-tendering process, have got thousands of crores of contracts. This is the story behind this Operation Money Bag.